I'm beyond thrilled to be here. That is the truth. I'm trying to learn to be a better Iowan because I consider that being a better person. And don't get me wrong. Listen, being from Louisiana and moving to Iowa, I always tell people it's not like necessarily better or worse. It's just different. It's very different. One of the first instances I remember where I recognized, whoa, 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 this is just way different, is when I first moved to Des Moines. I needed to do some shopping. And so I did as one does in 2012. I got on my computer, and I went to Google, and I Googled Shopping Mall Des Moines. And the first thing that popped up in the search results said Merle Hay Mall. And I was like, wait a damn minute, hold on. Because I had been living in Des Moines for a few days and I had seen nothing but white people. No disrespect there, any white people here. So I seen nothing but white people, and then I Google Shopping Mall Des Moines, and then it pops up Merle Hay Mall. And I wanna just be honest with you guys, Merle Hay is the blackest name I've heard in my life. So I'm like, wait a minute, who is this black person with a mall named after them in this white-ass city? And then I canceled my shopping. I was like, that can wait. I got important things I gotta figure out. So I go back to Google and I type in Merle Hay. And let me just tell you, it was an experience. So do any of you here not know who Merle Hay is? Okay, we got some hands going up. Real, I'm gonna do a quick history lesson, okay? Merle Hay is a gentleman. He grew up in one of the suburbs of Des Moines. I forget which one, it's not important. You just need to know, he grew up early 1900s in a suburb of Des Moines. And when he turned 17, he decided he wanted to enlist in the United States Army and go fight for us during World War I. Which was super brave. It was very courageous of him for the time. Super dope. And he actually did it. He went, he enlisted, he went off to World War I, and he was actually the first American soldier who got killed during World War I. And then all he got was a goddamn mall named after him in Des Moines. That's it. Do you know how mad that made my dumb Southern brain? It's not even the best mall in Des Moines. What are we doing, Iowa? We can't... Okay, so when I moved to Des Moines, I made a bunch of friends. Some of my friends are very conservative. And all last year, they come to me and they'd be like, hey, Dante, we cannot believe that you are out here saying publicly that you support Colin Kaepernick and those NFL players who take a knee during the national anthem. That is so disrespectful to the troops. And then I had to be like, bitch, first of all, Merle Hay got a damn mall named after him. That's the most disrespectful shit I've ever heard of happening to a troop. How dare you? I tried empathy. I'm telling you, I couldn't wrap my brain around what I was experiencing. I tried empathy. I was like, wait a minute, Dante. Put yourself in Merle Hay's army boots. Let's think this through from where he is. And I did, and I imagined it. And let's just say somebody built a time machine and they put me in this time machine and swapped me back to World War I. And there I am on the front lines in Merle Hay's army boots. And let's just say, guys, for argument's sake, just to make my point, I'm just the first American soldier who gets wounded during the war. So I show up, bam, they shoot, they graze my arm, and I'm bleeding out. And I know that all you get for being the first American soldier to die during World War I is a damn mall named after you in Des Moines. I just would have shot the dude next to me through the head. I would have been like, fuck this, y'all can give Jerry that mall y'all can't shut the fuck up about. Who I need to talk to about Dante Powell Memorial Library? I don't... You could put it in Waterloo. I don't give a shit. I don't want a mall in Des Moines that's not even the best mall. That was incredibly upsetting.